Welcome back to Let's Play Scratches. Director's Cut, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. What are we doing back over here? This is not where I left off last episode. Well, I must admit I did consult a walkthrough for the next few steps because I could not figure out what the hell to do. He has a note. Anything new? You know. It's this. I believe we want this. Maybe the pliers would be better. Right, okay. So we have this now. My zoological knowledge was as good as my technical expertise, but I was certain that claw had definitely belonged to a lion. Yeah, these next steps are very specific. So now we go downstairs. Downstairs is this way. We're making the amulet. That's what we're doing. And I think the only hint we have about is that state. That we cannot combine the two ingredients in the current state. I wonder if it says that about this too. So this. I couldn't blend those items together in their current state. Same here. Same here. So it wants us to blend all three in a way. And I forgot all about this because it's been forever since we looked at this thing. We put the tooth in. So now we have these were the remains of the tooth I ground. We have to. Everything closed and opened and stuff. Now we got that. Those are the remains of the claw I took from the gallery. We mixed them together. It was a mixture of human tooth and a lion's claw. Bizarre. Now we put that. The leaves were now mixed with dust from a tooth and a lion's claw. That wasn't useful. We're not done. It'll take me a while to figure this out. This is very King's Quest 3, kind of, with all the different things you have to cook together to make different spells and such. King's Quest 3 was the bane of my existence for, like, at least half of the 80s from when it came out. No, we're going up here. So I had the right idea with the stove. I just had to grind these two things and combine them. So I had to light it first, but can I put... I needed to have a flat surface first. Like this. Oh, on top of him. Look at that. Will you just look at it? Just look at it. Look at that. Alright, light the stove. Is that a mask lit behind me? See that? reflection on the stove? Oh no, it's the side of the chains. That sounds spooky. I do not like that. The stone felt warm to the touch. It was almost organic. Well, it is organic. I mean, you've got a claw, a tooth, and, you know, leaves and berries. It's all organic. Oh, crap. What? I do not like that. I'm not happy right now. I still hear it. I could turn around and look, but I get stuck in a loop sometimes. Plus, I don't think I'm gonna see anything. It's all over the house, right? I'm hoping, and not right next to me. Oh god, leave me alone. Just leave me the hell alone. No! To the mask. I'm guessing we apply it to the mask. As if it were aware of my intentions, the mask now appeared as if to defy me, challenging me to make the first move. That wasn't the proper way to use the amulet. Oh, right. I attached the stone to the branch and immediately felt a strange sensation. The amulet seemed to be vibrating. I was ready. I waved the amulet in front of the mask and then... At first nothing seemed to happen, but then the atmosphere felt lighter, as if the house had been relieved of a monstrous burden. Nothing else seemed to happen. Oh my god. It's the calm before the storm. Did that really fix something? I was afraid something was gonna happen. Something bad. It sounds like hopeful music. Alright, let me read his thing. I am ready to perform the ritual and finish what Blackwood started years ago. I feel weird doing this, because I'm not fully convinced of this story. But at least I have to try. I know something is wrong with this house and that mask. The mask is silent now, if such a thing can be said about it. Gone are the whispers in my mind and the constant presence around me. I feel relieved somehow and... How to say this? It's almost like the house feels the same way. Am I making sense? Probably not a single thing does now, but I feel fine. And that's only what matters now. Okay. Are we leaving? I could go right out to the car, but our stuff is in here. We leaving now? Grab the suitcase. No. Grab it. Okay. Take a nap? I had to leave this place as soon as possible. Yes, that's why I'm trying to gather my effects here. Okay. Maybe we're just gonna leave all this crap here. I don't know. If anything, we'll call Jerry. Whoa! I stood there, paralyzed in terror, as I heard those horrible noises again. They just wouldn't stop. From there, I'm guessing? Let me look there. Let me call Jerry. No, okay. Oh, brother. We've got an opening. An impressive... Oh. Really? Almost like some beast growling and snarling. Why are we doing this? As I went down the fireplace, I couldn't shake the feeling of entering a forbidden zone, a place that had been, and was supposed to remain, forgotten in time. Is this where we were seeing through from the furnace? Well, that's up to the fireplace. Whoever was here was living here. I bet you it wasn't Mr. Blackwood. He'd be an old man now. I bet you it's the child. The child wasn't dead. Or it could be the doctor. I mean, whatever happened to the doctor? I'm guessing it's the kid. The kid wasn't dead after all. But, like... ended up living somehow. The passage is full of junk, but, like, deformed or something. Pipes rusted long ago were everywhere in here. And the guy... James Blackwood didn't want the deformed child, or could be, forget my language, bastard child of the doctor and Catherine. Didn't want him inheriting the family fortune, so faked his death, and he lives here because it's the only life he's ever known. And he has alcohol to pass the time. I mean, really, for 20 years? No, 10 years. The only noticeable feature of the room was a filthy and cracked sink. These hidden rooms. Full of junk. The furnace of the basement was on the other side of this wall. So this is where we saw the figure pass through. It was in here. Oh god. In his... its... domain? I am not happy. I remembered being soaking wet and shaking with fear, yet I just had to go on, as if driven by an unseen force. Oh, don't start that crap again. Oh my god. Blood? So we can't see anything from where we are, we can only advance. Reluctantly, I do so. Not a very cozy place to live. There were remnants of food on the table. Someone or something had been eating down here. I'm talking about pipes there for some reason. What? A disgusting teddy bear covered in mud and dirt was lying on the ground. It appeared to be bites that had ripped its neck. Suddenly the words of William Bailey concerning the battery of Catherine Blackwood echoed in my head. Ripped, she would say. I'm turning around expecting to be someone right there. Do not like. Ripped, she would say. Some fresh water was dripping from a pipe. Okay. So we got water, we got alcohol, we got some kind of food. I mean, that's what you need to survive, pretty much. I'm not wanting to see what's over there. Traces of raw meat. It appears they had been dropped through the grating. Someone's feeding whoever's down here. Through the grate. Someone comes by here and feeds... something. Oh! What are you? What are you? Oh my god! Oh crap! That's the boy. Oh, it scared the crap out of me. That's the boy that... Robin!
Unsure of what I had just seen, I raced my car and left Blackwood Manor as quickly as possible.
No kidding.
I'm not ashamed of what I did.
Don't be.
That disfigured face is still stalking my nightmares, and I've never put foot inside a Victorian house ever since.
Really?
But there's certainly one thing that I'm grateful for.
My life.
It was thanks to my encounter below that house that I was able to finish my book and become a prolific writer.
Who comes by and feeds? It's gotta be Robin. Dropping the meat. This is Robin's point of view. Right? Oh my god. I was not expecting... Well... I don't know what I was expecting. We still have the DLC to play. Sort of, it's a DLC. Well, it's included on the CD, so I guess it's not technically downloadable content, but... Included on media content? Who comes by and drops the raw meat? The doctor? The doctor disappeared. Maybe it's Jerry. Maybe Jerry wanted me to become either the new caretaker or the new meat. For what I think is Noah. So, the doctor and Catherine were conspiring. Didn't really say what they did. It's like, no one can know what we did. That's the note we found in the locked drawer in a desk in the library. So they told everyone that Robin died shortly after birth. But in reality, Robin was born, I guess, disfigured, right? And they decided to let Robin carry on, live on, H.P. Lovecraft, thanks to H.P. Lovecraft, decided to let Robin carry on, and they were going to feed Robin, keep him alive underneath its water, alcohol, and meat drop down. Oh, it's a snow. That's the end. We can't save from here. So next episode is going to be the new, I guess it's a DLC, not even expansion, just an extra short story. Like, short compared to this, from what I've gathered. So I realize this is a short episode, but that's the way it goes. I don't want to mix the new stuff in with this. I mean, for all I know, that only plays for 15 minutes, but how... I have no idea. I'm playing this blind, as you guys should already know. Anyway, so stay tuned for the next episode when we go check out that. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.